Hey guys, it's episode 114. I'm here to color and finish off my Poofy bunny wolf drawing. And I call it Poofy because he's Poofy right there. And I'm going to start by coloring the hair and the black spots first with black, of course. So just going in through the hair beside the arm first. Now for this one, I didn't show me outlining it because you guys know I do, if you guys figured this out already, I sort of rotate based on what I'm showing for outlining and what I'm showing for coloring. Normally, I don't show both processes for each drawing. I think some of them I have shown both processes, but a lot of times I don't show drawing and outlining for both coloring and outlining for each drawing, because I want to rotate, and also I want to show new stuff, not really stick with the old stuff that I'm doing, and yeah. So just going through the hair that's in the front, and starting just going for this area that's behind the face more. And there. And now I'm going to go for the bunny ears. And just shade them first. Okay, and then I'm gonna color Poofy because he's like black too. And if you guys didn't see the stuffy I made him out of a sock, you guys can go check out that video too, because it actually has his colors there too. And it's super easy to make, and if you guys are familiar with how to make like round oval shapes and ears, he's super easy to make, so you guys can try it out. But I didn't do a tutorial for him because it takes too long for me to show that stuff, and it probably took an hour and a half for me to do because I'm slow. Now I'm just gonna shade part of his body. Just under anything that needs to be shaded. And now I'm gonna try to shade the hair. I can't find my sharpener right now because my brother has it somewhere in his room. So I'm just gonna have to try to use this as best as possible. Okay, and just shading behind the arms and the body. Ever it looks necessary. Shading on the bangs right now. Trying to get any strand of hair behind the body, overlapped by the body, anything like that. Okay, so the hair is done, and now I'm going to move on to the body, like the face and the arms. I'm gonna use light peach. I usually move from peach to light peach because I use skin color a lot, and basically these two are like becoming really small, and so is my black, so I try to alternate so I don't run out of them like I don't run out of one of them right away. So I'm just gonna go for the arm. But yeah, I need to buy, I feel like I wanna buy a set of like, I don't know if what's it called? Prismacolor has any separate sets with peach and black, because I don't want to buy another case again just for those, because I didn't run out of my other colors and I have like 60 colors in there, and a lot of them are like still pretty long and will probably last way longer. So just going in the face, already colored the neck because it's easy to find, and here, color under the eyes, beside the nose area and the mouth area, and just going in, avoiding the eye area as best as I can. And making sure there's white beside the eye area. And now this arm. And sorry, you guys can't see it, but the legs before the socks, the high thighs start. So right there. Yeah, I'm starting to do way more coloring and outlining drawings because that's basically the main point of my channel, but I haven't been doing that often. This is light pink, which I will be using for shading. Just shading the arm first. So yeah, I haven't been doing that often in the past 2 weeks, because that was exam week, and I'm pretty sure I said this in my other videos that I'm going to post, because I'm filming these all the week before I'm actually posting them, because I found out I had time to do that, and then I just kept coming up with different ones, videos that I wanted to make. But anyways, yeah, coloring the neck. But yeah, so I explained this in a couple of my other videos before this one will be posted. But yeah, they'll be posted before this one. But anyways, I didn't do much because I kind of ran out of stuff to do because I wasn't drawing much. So then I decided to draw some more just to try to keep up, and now I am all caught up, and that's why I'm able to do these videos beforehand instead of the day before or the day of when they should be posted. So, going on the other arm, and the hand. Hand has a lot of shading because everything's overlapping. Okay, and last part. Sorry, there's like bottles and cups up there, and that's why it's curving upwards. And my brother didn't clean his side of the table, and I'm using his side because mine isn't clean as well, but that's because we just ate, like, at 12-ish, and then I went and fell asleep, and my bad. Okay, and the body is basically, the body parts are done, except for the eyes, which I always leave last. So I'm going to start with the shirt. I'm going to use... okay, this is lemon yellow. It's pretty light. I'm just going to do these little lines that are like right here, like at the ends of the shirt and the sleeves of the shirt, and basically this will be left white because it's like those Japanese shirts, so I want that to be white because I'm sort of following the colors of a reference that I had, but I'm not really, but I don't have my phone with me, so I'm not exactly following, so I'm basically trying to make it my own. This is indigo blue. I'm gonna color the shirt that color. Since I am making these videos before the weekends and on the weekends, I don't exactly know if I will get a haul of stuff on Sunday. I did want to go to the mall, but my dad has went out on Saturday, which is the day I'm filming, but anyways, yeah. So he went out and he said not to go to the mall, and also my brother didn't finish his work, so I can't go anywhere. But also Sunday, I have a meeting for church, for children's ministry, and the thing is, when that meeting happens, I sort of can't go, like, places, because on Sunday everything closes really early, like, especially, I don't know about other places, but in Canada, because of, like, I think it's because in the old days, like, a long time ago, like, when people started going to church, it was, like, a law where you can't go to church, you can't work on Sundays because church is supposed to be, like, accessible to everyone, and so that's why they sort of, but nowadays we're more, law is more lenient on that, so they let people go to church, but it's not like a restriction where everything has to be closed down now, so yeah, but that's also a problem that I have to find a job and also tell them, like, I can't work on Sundays or Fridays. So this is porcelain blue, and I'm just going to shade. So yeah, that's, like, why I find it difficult. Like, if you want to go shopping on Sunday, nothing is really, less things are open late, so have to keep that in mind when shopping. I'm not sure about other countries though, if they do that, like, close early because of Sunday and stuff. So just shading. I decided to keep this area white of the skirt, and then it gradually gets, and then it's light blue, fading to indigo blue, fading to this porcelain blue up top. But I'm also keeping the puffy, soft parts of the skirt white as well. And then I'm going to keep this white, the shoes. I'm not really big on coloring shoes. I'm not sure. I'll just go for something, peppermint green. It's kind of close to the turquoise category, so it looks light and it kind of looks nice. There it is, the green, and I'm just gonna shade with aquamarine. I'm just gonna shade this part a little, and this part, sorry it's hard to see, it's like, so there it is. Before I go into the tail, I want to go into the ears. So I'm going to use pink again. And pink. Yeah, I'm just going to use pink for this. I was just, I was confused that I was using, I was confused if I was using this type of pink to shade this, but then I realized I use light pink, so I use the right color. And also his ears. We shaded too. Next is, sorry, I hit the tablet. Neon pink, which is slightly darker than pink. So this shading is harder to see, but it's there and it just gives a nice look. Okay. And his ears are pretty small, so shading kind of harder. And I'll color in his mouth. Okay, now on to the tail. I think I'm using dark gray. So I'm going in like this, and I'm gonna leave half of it white, but I didn't outline that part because I want it to be like flowing like fur. There, and also his. Okay. Now for the shading. Medium cold gray is slightly darker, so I'm just gonna shade here, some here, where the parts are being overlapped by clothing or body parts, and this line, because it's a curved line, so I'm just gonna shade there a bit, and also where the hair is kind of falling close in front of the tail. And now for this guy, Poofy. Okay, last thing I need to do and I'll be done is the eyes. So I'm gonna grab any light color of brown because they're pretty close to each other. This one is Sienna. I think I used it last time for my eyes, but two of the light color browns that I have are basically close, so I'm just drawing a little curve. Sorry, I think it's hard to see on tablet, on video, but yeah. And there is raw umber, and that's what I'm going to use to color the eyes, and I'm avoiding coloring too much on top of the light brown so I can actually see the light brown. Okay. And now it's finished. Just gonna close my pencil crayon and put it somewhere. Paper fell, darn it. Okay, so I'll give you guys an overview. Here it focus. Please focus. Here's an overview. I hope you guys enjoyed this coloring of Poofy, the bunny wolf, and yeah. Hope you guys enjoyed, and see you next time. Bye.